blue eyes for small boy. He's a little boy, so little. And he walk around like he know he does not even know. Oh, he's so little. Oh no. Oh no, he cannot sit in bed. He must sit in a different way.
Oh man, I'm so tired.
Yes. Yes, this is what we want. 10-0. Yes. And you see, there are many kinds of cola behind me. Because I'm special. Maybe if I got a nice pillow for my chair.
The idea of like sexuality and sexual politics, like gay, straight, bi, trans, etc. In my mind, the more you know about that stuff, like I don't really talk to people anymore. I don't talk to people my age. I don't think I've been really talking to people. Since at least 25, of course there's more to talk about than sex, but like, if you talk about sex a lot, if you talk about like being gay or being straight or like whatever, that's like initiation into the sexual world. And so like, assuming you were completely okay with having sex with men or women or intersex or whatever, being able to talk about that would open up a world of sex. And so I guess I've never really been into sex since like I'm officially straight. So the whole like gay pride, LGBTQ to what, you know, the whole thing. I'm trying to include everyone, blah, blah, blah. People are oppressed, and I'm not denying people are oppressed, but like, a typical straight person like me, or like even like worse than me, who like says gay things are wrong, they would have very limited sexual experience, I would think, than someone who is like educated in the politics and the whatever, the there's a lot to know about the subject. And the more you know about the subject, the more you can talk about it. And the more you can talk about it, the more you can have sex. So yes, these people are oppressed, like the straight white man, cisgendered, whatever, has more privilege and such, but, he's not getting as much sex, I would think. And I'm not saying that, if you're not straight, you're sexually promiscuous, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that you would have the ability to initiate conversation with a wide group of people. Yeah, I guess that has been said before. Anyways, I hope that wasn't offensive, because one should not talk about what one knows nothing about, and I don't know about that field, but I just... it's 6:23 a.m. and I'm waiting for my girlfriend to wake up and text me, so I'm sorry about that. So on the topic of when you shouldn't talk about what you don't know, my dad said to me, I marked my 8-month sober anniversary December 1st, so that was yesterday, but a week ago or so, my dad said, you haven't had alcohol in 7 months, therefore the lack of alcohol shouldn't be a problem for you. You shouldn't be suffering from it. I woke up at 1 a.m. today after sleeping maybe 4 or 5 hours. And I'm not blaming it on the alcohol, but my overall emotional disturbance is connected to alcohol, the lack of alcohol, adjusting to not having alcohol. One of the ways I adjust is caffeine, so that's a really obvious way in which lack of alcohol is affecting me negatively. But there's other, my psychiatrist said it would take 2 years before my brain chemistry became that of a non-drinker. And I don't know where you want to stand on science. A lot of people have faith in science, and just the older I get, the less concrete, and people who are into science hate it when you compare science to a religion, but it's a very wide field of study, and there are conflicting scientific views with scientific backing and scientific research on different things. So anyways, I don't know where, if you can say 2 years from now I'll be alcohol free. My point is, it's not a straight down the line cutoff point, and drugs affect everybody differently. I shouldn't be trying to speak because I'm too tired, and I hope I'm making a point. I'll just try to finish this thought. According to my psychiatrist, she would know best how this lack of alcohol thing works. Obviously, I could try to do AA. I'm not doing that right now. That's another digression. I'm sorry I keep getting away from the point. The point is, my dad thought that 7 months is long enough to go without alcohol, and I admit it doesn't tempt me anymore. It does tempt me, but when I was drinking every day, I would, around 4 o'clock be better get that beer. It's pretty important. The weather sucks outside, but you better go outside anyways. So, But just on a purely amateur, like just like on a human experience level, I think anyone who has been a heavy drinker and then stopped would tell you 7 months, you're still feeling it. You're still feeling the negative impacts of the lack of alcohol. And I separate that from scientific research because science really isn't a discipline, and it's very advanced, and it utilizes technology. But I'm just talking about like casual, if you meet one or even 50, like it doesn't matter. Someone who has successfully quit drinking, from what I know, almost everyone would say you're not over it 7 months later. And my mom says she knows people who have quit for like 20 years, and she says the people she talks to who have quit for 20 years, they say to her like, yeah, I'm still dealing with it. But anyways, yeah, that's just what I wanted to say. Like, I do believe that there will come a point when it's not something, I'll only worry about it like maybe once a month, or, you know, it would be great if I only thought about my abstinence from alcohol like once a year, if it only bothered me like that infrequently. But yeah, I just, Dad saying 7 months, like, the original point was like, you shouldn't speak about what you don't know. So, I mean, my dad is a casual drinker. I think most people, including people in AA, well, I don't know. Most people would say he doesn't have a problem with drinking, just because he drinks a very, like, compared to how I was drinking, compared to my mom currently drinks, compared to other people I know who are deep inside the alcohol thing. Like my dad might I don't know how much my dad drinks, but I'm guessing it's like, maybe he'll get drunk once a week, and by drunk I mean having like two or three shots or like of whiskey, and like, what I'm saying is it could be a lot more severe. So he's not completely ignorant about alcohol, but I don't think alcohol ever had a serious negative effect on his life. His own consumption of alcohol never had a serious negative effect on his life. So he doesn't have, I don't value his opinion. I'd say that 7 months I should be fine. Anyways, that's just me. And maybe I'm in diapers. Sorry about that. I've been holding this cord for like 5 minutes. And turn up the volume of the amp or whatever if I want to have more volume. And that people who like strum or pick really hard, they're usually trying to prove something. And it's a very convincing argument. And it has, especially the sixth string, it was giving me a bad sound. Maybe I have to crank it a bit more. Oh, or maybe it just adjusted. Anyways, the sixth string was giving me a bad sound, and when I was picking hard, it was giving me this. It did sound like it was proper musicality, and strumming light fixed that. So like, and this guy, like, he like, I seriously respect his guitar skills. He hasn't, like, really, I don't know, I'm not sure I've seen him play something that really impressed me. Not that he needs to, it just, I trust him. So he says, play light, always play light, and if you're playing hard here, I don't know. But that said, like, the last practice video I had, I was playing hard, and I was trying to play light, but then I got emotional and started playing hard, and I think there's something to, you know, and you know, sometimes a teacher, and I think this person has I don't know, but I would guess he has the ability to be a teacher. A teacher is a psychiatrist, psychologist. They will say something that's not like 100% true, but it's what you need to hear in order to progress. So my interpretation of what he said, now that time has passed, is that play light as often as possible. And like I said, I got emotional and I played hard, and I think it, to my own ears, it sounded good playing hard. I wasn't expecting to talk this much. And I haven't really been talking in the videos, so, you know, not many people watch. I've been doing these three chords repeatedly, and I'm hearing the same sound, and you know how music goes. Music gets boring if you hear it enough. But like, I'm like, watch this, like that final thing, the C to E, if you know music. So that's like a fast, the reason why that impresses me, I impress myself, am I allowed to impress myself, is because when I do brain stew, I don't know if you saw it, by the time I was here, my fingers were midway, they were in the middle of the fret, and the note still plays, but ideally your fingers should be as close to the fret as possible for the full sound. Anyways, I think that's enough with E. E was making me very empathetic. Just good for therapeutic counseling. Talking about the guitar, Jesus, I hope I don't have to explain that to people. I'm not on drugs. I had coffee and Coca-Cola and cigarettes. That's all that's going on. Classify me as an artist. Feels like disrespectful to my girlfriend. It feels disrespectful to dedicated, well, also paid, but like people who are more dedicated than me. Feels disrespectful to call myself an artist. Although I do spend a lot of time creating stuff that is really simplistic and whatever. And there's the idea of outsider artist. Why do I keep digressing? Anyways, so my life, I don't have a job, I don't go outside, I don't have friends, I have parents and my girlfriend, yet I still have so much to talk about and the need to talk. So it's kind of interesting, I think. So where were we? We just finished the... We did A. Did we do all of A? Let's do A again. Talking about this red-blue thing last night when I was asleep, and then I saw someone else post something about it, but this is something Melissa has told me a long time ago, and I don't fully understand what she means. It almost seems like pseudo-insanity, like contrived or learned. But despite that, I mean, it's solid. Like, if it didn't seem so contrived, it has the advantage of mystery, or like a thought that isn't explained. So in that way, it could be delusional. But now I'm thinking, like, since I heard someone else talk about it, like it's just like something you read about, and then you say, oh yeah, that applies to me. Whereas my delusions, I'm not writing. My delusions a delusion is a fixed false thought, but it's a thought that's, like, if you have a thought that the psychiatrist thinks is wrong, but the thought is shared by other people, the thought or belief or opinion is shared by other people, it's not a delusion, as far as I know. But if it's an individual with a belief, like, if I said,